If you have some experience with iOS, I'm pretty sure you've already used a date formatter or a number formatter. And you've probably noticed how much time these formatters save you versus if you'd had to write all of that formatting logic yourself. But did you know that Swift has more formatters than just these two? Let's have a look at five other formatters that come built-in with iOS. Number one, Date Components Formatter. As its name does suggest, Date Components Formatter is a close relative of Date Formatter. But whereas Date Formatter is great to format a given point in time, Date Components Formatter allows you to format quantities of time. A typical use case would be to format the amount of time remaining before the end of a lengthy operation, like when downloading a large file. Number two, Date Interval Formatter. Another close relative of Date Formatter is Date Interval Formatter, which allows you to format user-facing pairs of dates. It's a less common use case for sure, but any app that lets users handle calendar events might find it pretty useful. Number three, Measurement Formatter. Dealing with physical units is a nightmare, and it's definitely not a topic on which any iOS developer wants to spend their time and energy. So if your app displays any kind of physical measure to the user, you really want to make sure that you use Measurement Formatter. This little gem will take care of automatically converting and displaying physical measures using the correct unit according to the user's preferences. Number 4, Byte Count Formatter. Displaying the size of a file seems easy enough until you realize all the code that's needed to choose the appropriate unit depending on the size. Because no user wants to see a file size of 0.02 GB or of 1 million kilobytes. And that's precisely when Byte Count Formatter comes to the rescue. Number 5, Person Name Components Formatter. Formatting a person's name seems pretty straightforward. You write the given name, add a white space, write the family name, and that's it. Or is it? Because it turns out that not all regions of the world format a name using this convention. For instance, Koreans write the family name first and the given name second. And that's when Person Name Components Formatter can help take care of this for you. And that's it, we've completed our tour of Swift's built-in formatters. These additional formatters are definitely more niche than the more mainstream date formatter or number formatter, but the day you do need one of them, it will definitely save you a lot of time and effort. That's all for this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe so that you don't miss the next video. Thank you for watching and see you next time.